to order the Wednesday, November 2nd, 2016 meeting of the Board of Regional Commissioners. And please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Sorry. I jumped the under God part.
Please join us in a moment of silence as we remember all the men and women who have served in our armed forces, both here and abroad, and for those who have given their lives for us. Thank you. Is there anyone who would like to speak on public comment? Okay. And then we will move to general business. And the first item on our agenda is to vote to approve the final budget message. Mr. Kukunis.
You and I agreed a while back, and we gave Ms. Lyons a chance to weigh in on it. So. I'm prepared today to move our agreed situation where you wrote the, I'm going to call it the narrative, and then we're going to attach to the narrative the bullet points that I presented and send it on its way as a budget message.
Yeah, so, I'll second that.
Well, hold on a second, I got it written out here, but I do my glasses. Anybody see my glasses anywhere?
No.
God, I'm losing my mind here.
Do you leave them at the copy?
Where were you before you came in here?
I was out at the copying machine, but I'll find them. I'll find another pair in here, I think.
Is your memory good enough?
Well, but we'll see how my what do you call it is. Well, basically, on the budget message, yeah. I would move to approve and execute the budget message for FY 18 as prepared.
Yeah, I do have to change.
That's basically.
What I was thinking.
And again,
18?
Yeah, because 17, we already passed 17's budget. This is the creating FY 18.
That's right, 18. Okay, that's right.
And under discussion, Madam Chair.
Yes.
Again,
I'll second that.
Thank you. Just for the people at home and also our staff. This is a culmination of two things. It's you preparing an excellent couple of page narrative, and then I prepared and we have gone over a sheet with a number of different bullet points on it, which I have amended to as we agreed. So with that is what I'm referring to as a prepared budget message that I'm ready to move today.
Okay, so. And I second it.
Yep.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye opposed? None opposed, the motion carries.
I will do my best, Kara, if I may, through you, Madam Chair, to get you electronically both versions so you can combine the two of them, because I know I have a hard copy of the chairs, but that
I
way
have
do.
The draft version, so I just need the final.
Yeah, I can send you the one that I've done, and whatever, so just so you have it.
Thank you.
And the next item is the final evaluation for the Cape Cod Commission Executive Director. So I completed my numerical evaluation, and my written narrative is locked up in my computer at home. So I will just forward it in.
Well, you know,
but I don't see, it's not going to make any real difference. It's just a way of expressing some of my thoughts regarding his accomplishments.
And if I may, too, Madam Chair, I think we should allow the time to allow Commissioner Lyons to submit her narrative and her thing in. So I prepared a motion. Let me read it and tell me what you think, okay? I move to approve and submit to the Executive Director of the Cape Cod Commission the prepared rating sheets and individual narratives prepared by each commissioner for the director's evaluation for FY16. Furthermore, and I put this in there, in the event that Commissioner Lyons' sheets are not available due to absence, her completed rating form shall be included once received and not require further action to this board.
I'll second that. That's good.
That way there.
Yeah. I'm okay with that.
Yeah,
all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye opposed? None opposed, the motion carries.
And I think if you can, if you think of it, if you do have it electronically, let's just make sure that the human services. Justina gets it.
Yeah.
Yeah, for her files.
I have to get a new computer tomorrow. Hopefully they can transfer all my information.
I found them.
Oh, you did? Oh, there. They're right on the floor.
The carpet is dark and I couldn't see the damn things.
All right, so now we will move to, is there any new business? I have no new business.
No.
Okay, then we'll go to commissioners' actions.
All right, Madam Chair, if you will, I'll go through these individually because they do require a separate vote. Under A, the Cape Cod Commission Mass Emergency Management Agency one, I move to extend the period of performance through a State of Massachusetts Department procurement form for the pre-disaster mitigation grant program within the contract between Cape Cod Commission and Mass Emergency Management Agency from 9/30/2016 to January 31st, 2017, and the use of the remaining grant funds in the amount of $18,149.02 as presented.
Second.
Just for your edification, Madam Chair, I have run this by the Cape Cod Commission today because I noticed that both of these items, the next one we're going to do too, was for the emergency management hazardous mitigation grant, and this one is specifically for the pre-disaster mitigation grant. So that's why you'll notice that my motion language is a little different than what you see on your agenda, because again, these motions were approved by the Cape Cod Commission, by the way. So I just want you to know that.
Well, I thought it was interesting, and I didn't ask about the dates. On A, the date ends on January 17, and on B, it ends June 30th, 2017.
Well, they're two different.
They're two exactly
different programs, yeah. Right? And the reason why we're doing them two different ways, too, by the way, is because the first one, the contract has actually run out, September 30th. So we're November 1st right now. That's why we're specifically using what is called the State of Massachusetts Department procurement form to extend the dates. We're not doing a formal new contract or a contract amendment, different than B, which I'm going to read next.
An extension, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So.
All right. Do you want to?
Yeah, I made the motion. You seconded it.
Okay. All in favor, say aye.
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 Okay, on the second one, and this is an amendment to the Cape Cod Commission and MEMA contract also, I move to amend the contract between Cape Cod Commission and the Mass Emergency Management Agency to extend the period of performance for the Hazardous Mitigation Grant Program from 12/2/2016 to 6/30/2017 as presented.
No money?
Nope. I'll explain after a second.
Second for Thanks. Discussion.
I called on that, and the reason why there's no money is because, once again, this one we are in the time frame of the contract. The contract does not expire until 12/2/2016. All we're basically doing is just extending the dates. So there was no really reason to refer to the funding because the funding is not changing. Okay. Whatever is in that account as of today is all they're going to have to finish the year out.
So they don't need amended.
They did not need anything referring to dollar value on that. And again, that's because we are within the contract time frame of this. All we're doing is amending the dates, the contract dates.
Okay,
once again, these were approved by Nextdoor.
Right.
I just sent them over and they sent them back with a thumbs up.
So those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye opposed, none opposed, motion carries.
On number C, ratification action for Julie Ferguson. I would move to ratify the action of Julie Ferguson on approving the Memorandum of Understanding between the Children's Cove and the Cooperation of National and Community Service through e-grants to provide a VISTA volunteer for a one-year period from 10/6/2016 to 9/30/2017 as presented.
Okay, my question would be, is this the first time we will have a VISTA volunteer, or is this just another annual event where we contract with a VISTA volunteer?
To the best of my knowledge, yeah. This is the first time we've had
first
a VISTA
time?
Volunteer out at the Cove.
That's interesting.
And VISTA picks up all the expenses.
That's even better.
Yep, so there's no cost to the county.
And this is for Children's Cove. Okay.
So I made the motion. Did you second it?
I'll second the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. None opposed, the motion carries.
Cape Light Compact, creation of a new fund for pension liability retirement. I was kind of hoping Maggie was going to stay here, but she left. I would move in accordance with the county's responsibility as fiscal agent for the Cape Light Compact here and herein authorize the county accountant to establish a new fund for the unfunded pension retirement liability and other post-employment expenses to be funded solely by the Cape Light Compact.
Okay, second for discussion.
Okay.
This is something new?
Yes.
Well, but I want on record a couple of clarifications on this. Basically, we are being asked as the fiscal agent for the Cape Light Compact to establish a new reserve account for them. This is not doing a couple of things. Number one, it's not creating an irrevocable trust account, and it's not creating any type of a retirement OPEB account like we have done here at the county. This is it within the structure of the Cape Light Compact. They just want to have an area to put monies where they will be determining where it's going to be appropriated. Number one. Number two, and a little, like I said, I wish kind of I should have said something to Maggie. I thought she was staying. But this action will not satisfy any liability to the county's obligations for any return. It's just an internal reserve for the compact. So it's basically their accounting, because we're doing their accounting for them. They're asking us to do this. Yeah,
Commissioner Kukuna is 100% right. This is just the first step in the process of funding the unfunded liabilities that they've accrued.
Now, I normally would vote against this, and it's only because I want to know from now on when we create reserve funds, what is the policy and procedure of funding and disbursements for reserve funds? Because the county has been in the practice for a long time of creating reserve funds, and I mentioned this before, and Mary and I had a two-hour meeting in this room today about it. And the county is finally creating a policy and procedure on how we establish these reserve funds. And I'm kind of reluctant and hesitant to do this, but, you know, I'm willing to support it as long as I'm going on record that, again, in the future, I'm going to be requiring the policies and procedures for the creation of that reserve fund given to me first so I can see them and understand why we're doing this. Creating the fund, reserve fund first, and then getting that policy and procedure later is a bad practice.
Hmm. Well, I guess I'm in terms of understanding this, and I understand that they have to contribute to a pension retirement liability. It's not the county's responsibility.
Well,
it has been our responsibility.
We should have done this years ago.
Yeah.
That's my point, though. We're not doing anything here.
Right.
Please understand that. This action is you're not doing anything other than allowing the Cape Light Compact to take some money that they have in one account and put it over to another reserve account. It's not establishing an OPEB reserve account. It's not establishing a trust account. And it's certainly not reimbursing the county for anything yet.
Yet.
Exactly. I assume if I had the policies and procedures in front of me, I assume that that's what's going to happen, that the board would then vote from the reserve account to pay the county for their obligations. But this action is not that. This
right.
action is strictly just creating another line item, if you will, in Maggie's balance sheet, period.
Yeah, and that's, we have Siegel doing the ongoing study. So we get some numbers for you, and then we get back to address it again with you.
Right.
That's exactly right. It creates nothing yet. So
it just simply establishes an account.
Yeah.
It doesn't describe how the account is funded.
Right.
Or what funds it
or
says.
Or where it's going to go. I mean,
because
we don't have the policy and procedure. I mean, if we could wait, I have to tell you. I'm sorry, our accountant, finance director, basically had no idea of this. Today was the first day she heard about it. So, you know, I was a little kind of taken back by that fact. But we went over it, and again, the way it was explained to me by our finance director is that it's just strictly just establishing a reserve account for the Cape Light Compact. It's not a big deal. But if you certainly don't feel comfortable with it.
No, it's not that I don't feel comfortable, I just want to understand it a little better, where this is going, because over the years, the Barnstable County Retirement Board, I think, has received the pension funds, the contributions, I guess I should say, from the employees toward their retirement benefit already. And so it must, it, so I guess my question is, what happens to the funds that might be in the Barnstable County Retirement, and what type of how those funds would be handled if they're there? Do they stay there? Do they get transferred? And what does this really do? Does it really provide for the retirement benefits for the Cape Light Compact?
I think what, this is, what Leo says is accurate. Right now, it doesn't do anything.
It doesn't do a thing.
This is why we need the policy and procedures beforehand. Basically, though, the way I understand this is right now, I know, and I'm going to use the OPEB, for example. I know that Cape Light Compact, through their board, has said, let's take $300,000 and keep it aside for our OPEB obligation. Now, by saying that and doing it on paper are entirely two different things. You just can't take $300,000 and put it aside somewhere. You have to have somewhere to put it. And this is creating a line item for the director and the board to say, let's put some money aside. Now, they may use it for their obligations to the retirement, because right now the check from the retirement check comes to the county, and then the county sends it in with our payment. So this might be a stopover in their accounting world, where the director would funnel money into it and then appropriate, probably not from that reserve account, but appropriate to the budget, and from the budget to us, then from us to the retirement board. This is no way going to affect the retirement board or anything like that. It's just a stopover.
This is all internal, right?
All internal.
Right. And the
which is currently unfunded.
Right.
And now it, the account will be,
it'll be stopped. It'll be stopped.
And it will,
in
the
defense of
Maggie,
I would argue that it is
county
funded.
Retirement system.
I think she's got money set aside okay already, but it's not in its own unique account.
Right. It's just set aside.
So does that mean that they would no longer be county employees?
No.
This has nothing to do with that. Nothing to do with that. Yeah. Like I tried to explain, Maggie, I don't mean to keep using personal names, but the director has taken $300,000 of their budget and set it aside in a line item for future appropriation for OPEB. Well, it just can't hang out there in Never Never Land. It has to be put into a reserve account.
This is really separate from retirement. It's
absolutely
benefits. Yeah. Okay.
Absolutely. It's basically just a line item, adding another line item for the board to be able to funnel money into, and a reserve account funding it. It has nothing to do with their obligations, nothing to do with us and funding us, and certainly nothing for us to put money into. I think I got
so is that written recognition that they would not be eligible for any OPEB? Any OPEB funds that the county has set aside?
Under the Administrative Code, Section 1.4, you will ultimately direct the policies and procedures for the Cape Light Compact subcontractors, or our employees, basically. And at some point, you may determine that this OPEB money has to go into an irrevocable account. These are the policies and procedures that Leo's talking about creating. But for now, their board, in order to continue in the funding mechanisms they have with PPU, wants to create this reserve account to show the world that they're starting to address the issue of the OPEB monies. So,
I mean, this was, it's strictly internal, though.
Yeah.
I cannot stress that enough. Strictly internal to the operation of the Cape Light Compact. It has nothing to do with our relationship with them, other than we're doing their books.
Okay. I'm fine.
So
I think I seconded, did I not?
Yeah, you did for discussion.
Then I'll call for the vote. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? None opposed. The motion carries. So, commissioners' reports.
Are we there already?
Approve the certificates for dissolved betterments.
Oh, yeah, so, thank you.
That's right.
I move to approve and authorize the chair to execute the certificates of dissolving betterments as presented.
Second. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye opposed? None opposed, the motion carries. Now we go to commissioners' reports.
Madam Chair, a couple of things I want to bring you up to date on, and unfortunately, my notes here are a little old because I did some of them last night. The draft lease agree, license agreement that I have been working with your direction, and actually I think Ms. Lyons was also here with the county council, has been completed, and we presently the town of Orleans, and I got notice today from the lawyers for Orleans, they're looking it over, and hopefully we'll be moving forward pretty quickly on that, because there was no undiscussed things in it. It was pretty cut and dry, so I just want you to let you know that that's moving forward. The only other question I have, and I don't know if the county administrator, a couple of things. Do you think we'd be talking about, or maybe possibly putting the goals and objectives for the county administrator back on the table again if we have some time?
Yeah, I wanted to check with Jeff to make sure that he was ready to present them to us. And any time you are, we can put it on the agenda.
Good. The other thing is, I did meet, I had a question in here about policies and procedures for financial matters, but I did meet with our finance director today, and I know where that's going, and hopefully we, I think we have a dead, probably a date of about December. In December we'll be getting back that,
yeah,
and the board
good.
Will be able to weigh in on it. I noticed, and I sent out to Jack, I did not forward it to the commissioners, but the town of Provincetown has voted, taken an official vote of the Board of Selectmen in Provincetown to become the new fiscal agents of Cape Light Compact.
Oh.
And through the chair, I would like to ask Jack if he's aware of that or if he has gotten any update on it.
I haven't.
Possibly can update us about it later.
I haven't, but I bet I'll hear about it today at the assembly.
Okay.
Because I am on the agenda to update them on sales seat.
So rather than the county, Provincetown.
Possibly.
Will be possibly.
It's still going to be approved by that. I think it, I don't know if it's going to be approved by the town meeting, but it has to be approved by the Cape Light Compact Board, so, of which we are one vote of 22.
Well, the way I understood their vote, again, just to give you an update on the commission's report, because I don't want to discuss it, but. And I will send out and maybe make public the a meeting so you can just watch the meeting. But under their at the selectmen's meeting, they did voted, and they voted to research what it's going to take in order to do it. And I believe they allocated their administrator, town administrator, to do all that work. So he'll probably be reaching out to Jack and I'm sure to Maggie to get what he needs. That's all I have.
Okay. Administrator's report. What I have to say, I'm not allowed to say. So.
Let me start with the Department of Human Services. I saw Patty. I just lost Patty, but
she wasn't able to stay, Jeff. But she handed me those.
Oh, okay. Yeah. The Department of Human Services, in partnership with the Bonneville County Regional Substance Abuse Council, which is a collaboration of about 40 parties, including the sheriff, the DA. The drug courts, probation, most of the police departments have been working extensively on the substance abuse problem and how it's impacted Cape Cod. On the 20th of November, at the Cape Cod restaurant over in Hyannis, they're hosting a program to inform parents about how to discuss this issue with their kids, how schools should be addressing it in a more descriptive manner and so on and so forth.
Can't just slap them side the head anymore.
Yeah, be good old
like
things.
They did when we were kids.
Yeah. Don't remember the nuns with the metal rubber pad?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
My knuckles received a few of those.
So it's really a forum to get the parents engaged. And they asked, the department asked me, Beth asked me to make sure that you knew about it and, of course, invite you to come on by if you can on the 20th, Sunday the 20th. So that's that, and I know they put a huge amount of effort into this, so I imagine it'll be a great success. A few more things. Steve Thibault and I today met with Dr. Bob Dutch and Bob Sanborn, superintendents of Upper Cape, and Cape Tech to talk about internship opportunities with their kids. And we breached a number of the possible department work we could do with them, from the dredge, fire service, the extension. There's just so much we could do with the kids at these two schools, and IT in particular. So it was a great meeting, very positive. We're going to get together again in 2 weeks to see if we can start working with their teachers, staff, to draw up some internship programs on relevant fields. It would be a benefit to us in terms of helping our department heads do more. Mm-hmm. And it certainly would be a benefit for the kids, learning how to work in a real world environment. So, and you know, this is an idea that really had its seeds, and Commissioner Kukunis suggesting that we talk to these folk tech people a couple months ago, and it's really paying off now. So it was a great meeting, and two superstars in the folk tech world. I'm in Truro tonight, Board of Selectmen. Monday is Brewster, and I think the only one we have left is Dennis, and I think we're just waiting for Dennis to get a town manager situation in order. I would assume, I haven't heard from him for any other reason. And finally, on the Fire Training Academy, it's not fixed yet, but I'm going to ask Kiara to schedule another executive session for the next Wednesday. Bob Cox would like to come back and update you again on some of the conversations that have occurred between the town and him in the last week or so, and where he thinks we have to go next. So if that'd be okay with mm-hmm. you all, I'll add that to the agenda next week.
That would be very good, yes.
I don't think it'll be as long as the last briefing, but I'm sure it'll be important. So we'll do that.
Okay. And maybe we can get to the point where we have enough closure that we can actually announce something. Mm-hmm. Because everywhere I go, people ask that question.
Yeah.
You know, what is the status? What are you going to do?
Yeah. And my indications are, once again, that it has not been contentious, and we're working in the same direction, so we'll have to wait and hear from Bob. I should make up to the audits are almost done, and I think they'll be pretty much done with their field work by the end of this week, and then we'll wait for a more formal briefing.
Okay.
We'll probably get a sub-briefing and then a final report in the course of the next couple months. So.
Yeah, can they give that to us, too?
Oh, absolutely.
Together?
Absolutely. Oh, it comes to you.
Yeah, that would be great.
We're an afterthought, yeah. It's your request to bring the auditors in. You get the reports, and the briefing will probably be here.
Yeah, so we would have them prior to the meeting, so
yes.
If we had questions,
right.
we could ask questions.
Yep.
That's good. Because since I've been out and about around the county, those are some of the questions, not auditing specifically, but some misunderstandings regarding the financial position of the county. And it's actually been very nice to be able to say that we closed out this year in a very positive note. But we still are aware that we have sort of an unsustainable source of revenue. I mean, it's irregular, and it's not dependable. So that is something that I don't know how we work that out, but we could address that at some point.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep. Sounds good. Thank you.
Okay. Any comments?
No, I think I'm all set. Yep.
Okay. Motion to adjourn.
Double.
Second. All in favor, say aye. Aye. We are adjourned.